Hey, Jason here, and today I am talking about shape keys, how you're putting shape keys on finger gestures, and how you should be able to have multiple layers of different shape keys. Meaning, that under certain conditions, you can have like one set of shape keys on the right hand, and if a condition changes, you have another set of shape keys. Yeah, just going to do the basics today. So first things first, we are going to duplicate our avatar like always. Put our lovely effects into here. And what we are doing now is to simply create like one or two gestures we want to make. Animation, we click on create new clip. And we say our white hand, because I want to do a white hand animation. I get a new folder and we just make a simple blush. For that, we click on our body once, hit record. We are looking for the blush right here. We just set it to 100. That's good. And we do a second one. We want to smile. Where's our smile? Where it is. Oop. It looks more funny than good, but we just take it for now. It's just an example. We want something for our left hand as well. What I personally like to do is to do mouth and blush stuff on the right hand and eye and eyebrow stuff on the left hand, so I can mix them anytime. And just call it VTF because we are going to use Hachu Eye here. Where is it? Hachu Eye on 100. 1 keyframe long as always. And we make a second one, eyes closed. We are going to use. I would like to use blink, but blink does not necessarily work since blink is used by the avatar itself blinking. So we have to look for something else. Probably you use blink happy. So our normal blink, we get rid of it and we set blink happy. Our first keyframe. And what we are doing next is to create the idle face. We do it by creating a new clip. Idle face. And this idle face has to have every shape key we are going to use with our hands. So we are going on add property, body, skin mesh renderer. We are using blink happy, right click, add properties. We're using blush, property. What are we using as well? Hachu Eye. And we are using smile. Get rid of new. Okay. We are going to set that on the first keyframe again. So again, we are using this idle face to reset every shape key we are using. And we have to do next is to make sure that these are non-looping animations. All of them, of course. And right hand as well. Non-loop. Non-loop. And with this, we are going into the animator. In the animator, we have to add two parameters if they are not already there. You can find these animators on the VRChat site. It's gesture left and gesture right. And it is going to tell you which value is for which gesture. So we are going to add one integer, gesture right, add another integer, gesture left. You have to write it how it's written on the Vietchat side, otherwise it won't get recognized in game. We are going to add three new layers. So we just call this one idle phase. Once. This one is left hand. And this one is right hand. Weight one X mask, of course. Because we are not moving the bounds, we are just working with shape keys. So what we are doing in idle phase. In there we set our idle phase, of course. By default's off because we don't need that. So what this is doing is it is constantly setting your phase to the values we set in there, meaning all shape keys zero. Next we are going to the left hand. And because I don't have it, we are going to create one more animation. Underscore idle, which is empty. And this is our default state here. So, what we are going to do now, left hand, we put in eyes closed, and what the fuck? Void defaults off, of course. And now we have to choose from the given list to which gesture we want to bind it. So, eyes closed, I will bind it to hand open, which would be 2. I make a transition from any state to eyes closed. And the condition is gesture left equals 2. And for the VTF, we are just going with 3, which would be finger point. I'll make transition to VTF. Gesture left equals 3. And now, example, we are doing the finger point. It goes to the VTF. But if we are leaving finger point, it would stay here. So what we are doing is we make another transition to idle. And tell it gesture left not equal 3. That means as soon as we leave the finger point, it goes to idle, or if it happened to be one which fits another condition, like this one, it directly jumps to here and does not go to idle. Same for you, make transition gesture left. Not equal 2 in this case, because we use the 2 to get here. Go to idle. Defaults off. And we are doing the same for the right hand. We put the idle in here. Sorry, double clicking issue. With my mouse, I need to buy a new one soon. Right hand. Put the blush in here. Put the smile in here. Look up our nice list. We do that just and open finger point as well, meaning 2 and 3. You, when you are gesture right, equals 2. Right defaults off, of course, for both of you. And you stop blushing when gesture right not equal 2 anymore. And you begin to smile when gesture right equals 3, meaning finger point. And you stop smiling gesture right not equal when we are not finger pointing anymore. So, just to explain very, very shortly what's happening. We are setting our idle phase all the time. If, however, left hand or right hand does a finger point, it activates the animation here, and in this case it sets the smile. As soon as we are not smiling anymore, we either go to blush directly, or we are going to idle. However, since we have not set smile anywhere else, idle face will make sure that our smile gets set to zero again. So with this, we are able to upload her already, but I'm going to put her into play mode to show off what we just did. So, getting the animator, you see idle face is running. So gesture right, finger point, he's smiling. If he set it back to zero, she stops smiling. If he set it to two, she should be blushing. And if he directly set it to three, that means in-game we are just changing directly to finger point. Boom. Because the idle face is making sure everything which is not set is zero. Same with gesture left, Pikachu eye, the closed eye. If we set everything back to zero. Yeah. Okay, I'm going to upload her. We are seeing us in the chat very soon. One thing I always forget to mention, that's why we are not in the chat right now, in our animator. I always forget to tell you people in the base layer to delete all the animations that are in here because we don't need them.
See you in the chat.
Okay, the reason why I am going VRChat this time after the tutorial is basically to tell you why I am doing the shape keys like this. So my right hand, if I point or open the hand, does lower face stuff like the mouth and the blush. And this enables me, if I'm doing the left hand as well, to combine the shape keys of right and left hand however I want to. And this saves like some spaces that basically enables me to have up to, don't let me lie, 30 different combinations of shape keys. I'm not using them all, of course, but it's just a little hint that you are able to do a lot with